Hey guys, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I want to thank you so much for the continuous support, suggestions, and phone calls. Today's vlog, we look into the cost to develop a goat house. I've seen a lot of young farmers out there getting themselves together, and one limiting factors I think affect a lot of their operations is infrastructure. Housing is definitely one of them. And we're going to see how is it that we can improve. So let's talk to Mr. Aniel.
You don't want to get a better book like one of them Nubian book they are.
Yeah,
man. Or one of them boar book.
Just take time and review you, you know?
And this one is how old?
That one of those. You know, read 1 month fully. About 3 weeks.
3 weeks old?
Yeah.
The natives, them strong. My concern is the condition where you have them, you know? Where so your mortality
rain,
like?
The rain, the rain where they have. You know, really have to like, take it off of the ground. Leave them some bullets and stuff.
It's a better feel.
It's a better feel.
No doubt. Because it looks kind of messy. But yeah. my concern is, do you have a lot of mortalities? I mean, a lot of death.
Well, yeah, but come on. Not really. It's sick.
I don't really see.
Just be here or then just spawn and just do a time and then just pass.
Sorry, when animals then give birth, do you have a lot of mortality at kidding? Or is after kidding?
After kidding.
So what age group normally die on this farm?
Like 1 week to a month, couple of months.
And then they must drop out?
Yeah.
I get you, Papa.
There's some more
around. Oh, so they may a curry animal them?
Yeah.
So who you sell the curry them to?
Well, normally kill them myself and sell them, you know.
Kill them yourself?
Yeah, like cut them up and sell them. Like,
in your community?
One can afford a goat and then can buy the pound.
Oh, you sell them just like we say, buy a 1 pound of meat?
Yeah, 4 pound, yeah.
So you sell them, how much you sell it for a pound?
Well, you know, kill them, you know, it's just $1,000.
$1,000 a pound?
Yeah.
Fair enough. So tell me why you do goat farming, though?
Well,
born in it?
Yeah, man. You know, it's from a child, you know. So. Kinda like it, but through high school, lose everything. I don't start back fresh from since we get big and finish school, big opera. And decide to just go back into the business.
So how long now you're back into the business?
About 2 years.
2 years?
Yeah. For me, I arrived with about 48 for myself.
48?
48 for me.
Too much in the evening.
Yeah.
Which is smart because at the same time the sun kind of go down, so you're not too hot.
Too active and you're not too hot, so then kind of stand up and feed more.
Food well, smart. Yeah, a lot of farmers kind of put out the animals too early and then them say, boy, because once me daddy and say, boy, because the animal now put on a weight.
No, I now put on weight because when you put him out early, I do what I eat. When you can eat one by the sun, come up and just
lay down. Lay down for the rest of the day. Yes, boss. You know where I'm going. No, it's important to take them animals off of the ground.
Yeah, man. And I lose a couple of them last year because of the same old problem with the water.
Yeah.
I'll be trying to take them off of the ground.
Yeah, brother.
That's possible.
Alright.
Yeah. Building a goat house in Jamaica is no longer taboo, as I say, farmers developing this low cost pallet was very popular across Jamaica. It's definitely a raised floor. I think this is a very good indication that farmers are looking to be very cost effective in their business model, as a housing can be very expensive, especially using a particular type of material. The lumber prices are very high, so these established lumber houses are quite a little bit more expensive. Farmers have a serious decision to make in determining their startup costs, is that they're going to go either palleted or lumber. And there's also a big debate over raised floor houses versus concrete floor houses on the ground, which I believe both are applicable in our conditions. However, there is some disadvantages and advantages to selecting this type of housing. The major advantage of the raised floor is definitely manure management and the impact that it has on your labor costs regarding cleaning and sanitation, and just the overall management of the animals regarding medication. So we think goats preferably should be raised. I push for that. I see it as a more lucrative business venture and more sustainable. So let's go down to the common question. What is the cost to build a goat house, especially in Jamaica? And this is where I did a little market research for us to look at the cost for the materials. So here we go, guys. Let's talk about the scenario. The scenario that we have is that we're looking to build a house for, say, 50 heads. I mean, ideal for about 30 breeding females. We're also looking at a pallet and lumber mix. And we're going to also take into consideration that we're doing a raised floor housing, which is perfect for our tropical climate and for our management system. And we're going to look at different levels of lumber type, which is probably the only factor that changed the cost. So let's talk about a 25 by 25 lumber house, where we're using strictly lumber flooring within this house. I would leave the bill of quantities here for you guys to review it after. But if you're looking at a 25 by 25 size house, the major cost for this comes from your lumber. Treated lumber, the 2B, 4B, 20, the 1B, 3B, 16, they are really expensive. You're looking at over $1.2 to $3 million just to purchase this lumber. It's pretty expensive. We also do using chain link fence around the sides. And the next high price item on this list is your zinc. Zinc is very expensive. We use around 20 pallets to assist with making the side of this pen. And that's the type of costing you're looking at. The labor costs about $130,000. This house could roughly take you around, you know, a month to be completed. And if you're looking at it, it'll be around $2,720 per square foot, which includes material and lumber, and a grand total of spending around $1.7 million to get a house like this fully constructed and ready for your animals. Let us now shift to the alternative approach that a lot of farmers are doing, and I really give them kudos for that, which is the 25 by 25 pallet house. And they use majority of the house, especially the flooring, made out of pallet, and this significantly reduces the cost for the house. So the most expensive thing again for this type of house would definitely be the lumber that will be used. However, you increase the pallet by around 60%, still using that chain link fence around the side, but we can see that just the board cost alone is roughly around $300,000, in that range. The zinc again will remain the same, which is again probably one of the most expensive items. But a house like this would definitely cost you $750,000 compared to that $1.7 million that we saw earlier. So there's a significant reduction in the per square feet cost, which is about $1,184 per square foot, which includes the material and the labor. So I believe this is the simple approach for a lot of farmers to put this type of system in place, to reduce the housing costs and make it more affordable. And they can even be way more innovative than this, which I know our Jamaican farms are, because we can definitely have some savings on the zinc. We can also remove the chain link fence from the windows, and that would reduce the cost. But say, for example, now we're going to the commercial farmer, a farmer who's thinking around 300 heads, and we're looking at a 40 by 100 foot house, which is strictly made out of lumber. And this is where the big bucks come into place. So the cost to develop a house that's about 40 foot by 150 feet can run you around $5.6 million if you're using strictly lumber. The lumber cost is ridiculously expensive. So a house with this size, I'll definitely trying to look into using as much pallets as possible and all the material to address a house of this size. So what can we learn? Pallets are the way forward in reducing your housing costs. So try, you know, get yourself a pallet link or somebody who can sell your pallets for, you know, like between $500, $600. The pallet use is versatile. It can be used for your floors, can be used for the sides, can use for the partition walls on the inside. So pallets are definitely beneficial to a goat operation housing. Another consideration is the alternative of using blocks as the upright post compared to bush posts. And we know that lumber costs is very expensive, so a lumber house is expensive, but we can be innovative and even use bamboo as a partition, which is a cheaper material to use for your housing. So thank you guys for watching. The next time now we're going to look at, yes, we have this housing cost in, so we're going to look at what is it that is required to run operation of a 50 head animal unit, and we're looking to the cost of production, operational costs, and compare it to the profit that can be made from this operation. This is just the beginning. Look out for part 2.